Welcome back, DPReview TV viewers. Chris Nichols here with a special video, joined by my special friend,
Jordan Drake, talking normally. Are you going to do that all night?
Friggin' rights, boy. Absolutely, eh? Celebrating our history, because 2020, quite the year. So this is the long-awaited Best and Worst of episode. We want to bring you guys some holiday cheer. We've got a whole Canadiana set going on here.
This has been a classic Chris and Jordan tradition for many years. Like those other years, we're also going to have a drinking game.
Absolutely. Let's get right to it, eh?
Stop.
Okay, I'll stop. So for our drink of choice this year, we decided to go with shots. I know you guys have always been saying, oh, we should do something a little bit stronger. So here we go.
I didn't say that.
We're going back to, not my childhood, but when I basically came of drinking age in Alberta, which luckily is 18. And we're having the B-52. This is actually a little bit Canadian trivia. A Canadian bartender invented this based off of one of his favorite bands, the B-52s. So we can cue Love Shack music right now.
We cannot afford Love Shack.
Well, basically we got, you know, a coffee liqueur. We've got an Irish cream, and then we layered it with a little orange liqueur on top. It's going to be lovely.
So for our game this year, we're going to go with Headbands, a classic. I don't know if it's really a Canadian game, but we thought we'd make it a little bit interesting by reaching out to some of our YouTuber friends and kind of the camera, video, tech space, people we know, but we want to get to know better.
We've got them to give us two facts. One being a very challenging, obscure fact that
something
very
that
few people should
know. Almost
no
one knows about.
I assume that they're safe for YouTube video. I have no idea.
I hope not.
I have no idea. And then another fact, which will be much more commonly known, hopefully easier to guess. Okay,
so
I'm going to ask you the hard one first. If you get it, I drink. If you don't get it, you drink a shot. And then I'm going to ask you the common one. And again, same thing. If you get it, I drink. And if you don't get it, you drink. Put on your band.
All right. Okay. Do I look cool?
I mean, you look cooler now. This YouTuber plays piano and guitar, I assume proficiently.
It could be Donna or Gerald. I'm going to go Donna.
You are going to drink, sir.
Ah.
You are going to drink. Here's the common fact, all right?
Okay.
I think I'm going to drink on this one. They have a dog named Pixel.
Oh, it's Chelsea.
It is Chelsea North of...
All these YouTubers are so musical, except you. All right, the difficult one. This YouTuber has tried steer wrestling and failed painfully at it.
I'm going with an either a Texan or an Albertan. Is it Tony Northrup?
It is not.
Drink.
Common fact, their current favorite mirrorless brand for video is Panasonic. Someone with taste.
Ted Forbes.
It is Caleb Pike.
Oh, what? I still like them. All right, so let's get to our categories. We've got best lens of 2020 in third place. We're giving it to the Nikkor 70-200 2.8 for a Z mount. Z, eh?
And stop it. No more.
Z's are for snoring. And the 70-200 2.8 is up there because this is an incredibly sharp telephoto, and it carries on beautifully from the 70-200 2.8 VR SLR lens.
Number two is going to go for the new Sigma 85mm f1 for DGDN. Now, Sigma is synonymous with lenses that you need several pack mule to haul with you when you go out. They're oversized. They've been very good. However, this is way smaller than we were expecting, and optically there were no compromises at all, and it's still very affordable for an 85-1.4. It's an easy pick.
In first place, we're actually going to give it to the Sony 12-24 2.8 for E-mount. I mean, it's an awesome lens. You know, normally we weigh a lot of these lenses based on value for dollar.
Right.
But the fact of the matter is, although this lens is really expensive, it's also fantastic optically.
But how could it be so good optically when the E-mount is so small, people ask me?
I just said because it's really expensive.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Now, we do also want to say we have an honorable mention for best lens of 2020. It's the Tamron 70-180.
Yeah, I mean, it's very compact. The price is really great on it. We just did a roundup of all of the 70-200s, most of which were fantastic. This is really competitive for like half to a third of the price.
But how can they do it with such a small lens, Jordan?
Because the price is very small. That doesn't square with what I just said last time.
Right? Yeah.
Okay.
This person once worked in a cafe that only sells tea. They were hired to clean up raw sewage, which had flooded the basement. Sadly, this is also where the kitchen was. Great, never eat there again. They obviously never ate staff meals there again while working there.
I feel like they're really thoroughly explaining a concept, so
yes.
I'm gonna say Ted Forbes.
No, you are gonna drink,
sir. Oh.
You think Ted Forbes is overly verbose? Did you hear that, Ted? They once did a durability test on an L lens for a video idea, but they couldn't finish the video because it was broken on one of the first tests. But and they couldn't because it didn't work.
And it's not
DPReview. It was already broken.
I'll say Gerald.
No, it was not Gerald. I'm done.
Okay.
Drink your drink again. We're tied now.
Who
3-3.
Was it? Who was it?
This was Kai Wong. Yeah.
I said not DigiRev. I didn't know Kai got back to us.
So I just remembered, you kind of messed up the rules. Like, if I get the hard question right off the bat,
yes.
You have to have two drinks.
Oh, this fell.
Yeah, clearly.
Okay. This YouTuber was in the Canadian Army as an engineer for 6 years.
I think Justin was at Wainwright. He looks like he's killed a man before, or at least could. I'm going to go with Justin Dunna. Dunna.
Nope.
Oh, what?
They like the color purple.
Instinct. Jordan, you're going to have a drink because it was Gerald Undone.
That's correct. So this is really what you were drinking when you were 18 years old?
This takes me right back to like nights at the back.
Because I was like Smirnoff like ice coolers.
Smirnoff
like,
ice? No, man. What was,
like, what was the big frosted bottle? It was like sparkling like fruit juice wine.
Arbor Mist.
Yes, Arbor Mist. That was.
18-year-olds are stupid.
We were not good at life yet.
All right. Next category.
Next category is best hybrid camera. Now, we haven't been reviewing video cameras or big cinema cameras or anything like that. So these are ones that take good pictures, but really function as exemplary video cameras. And in number 3, it's gonna be the Fuji X-T4. Now, I love the X-T3. I bought an X-T3 as a video recorder. I love the image out of it, but the battery drove me crazy. The lack of IBIS was a real drawback, and they addressed both of those. And the picture is still straight out of camera, my favorite video image right now. So, number 3.
In second place, we're gonna give it to the Panasonic S5. In fact, it's shooting me right now. You know, you want a compact mirrorless camera that can do good video, but this camera takes it further. We get 10-bit internal video, you got RAW support, waveforms. These are tools that you often do not find in the competition. That earns the Panasonic S5 a solid number 2.
You talk so fast and so good, even with all these drinks. You're
what?
Amazing.
Shut up!
Best hybrid of the year, no question, it is the Sony A7 S3. And I kind of felt like Sony lost the plot a little bit. I wasn't very excited by their video offerings for quite a while. Then I made a video, what I want from the Sony A7 S3. And then 3 weeks later, they released pretty much exactly what I asked for. And even some stuff I didn't, like a crazy fast scanning sensor. I love shooting on this camera. It went back to Sony and I miss it every day.
That's because you've got the touch. Okay. This YouTuber is a Juno-nominated music producer and recording engineer, and that's been their full-time job for the past 8 years.
Well, that's Donna. 2 shots.
How do you know that?
Mother effer.
How do you know that?
I pay attention. He was on Dave Mays' podcast.
I'm sure he's a lovely guy, but he looks like he was in the Army.
Also, I called it Dave Mays' podcast. No one will know what it's called, and no one will go listen to it.
You did it. Did a real service.
Yeah, really helped a brother out there. We're going through the award winners because this YouTuber won an animation contest for Nickelodeon when they were 16. The trip was a grand prize trip to Burbank, California with their whole family. They got a tour of the Nicktoons Network studios and they ended up on TV.
They're American. Gary.
It's
Gary
not,
Everyday Dad.
It's not Gary.
Oh my goodness.
Drink. And while you're throwing that back, they used to be a professional magician.
Okay, that's unfair because that's every single YouTuber. Oh, Dave Mays.
That's correct.
Yes!
Add-on fact, this YouTuber met Peter McKinnon at a magic conference since he's also a magician.
Right, that's what I said. They're
all YouTubers are magicians.
That's the scam. YouTube is all magicians. Oh.
The most honorable pursuit.
It is best camera of 2020, and we're going to give third place to the Nikon Z5. You know, we've seen a lot of cameras come out this year, but they've been expensive, and the Nikon Z5 gives you so much for such an affordable price point. It's a refreshing breath of air. Fresh air.
You're doing great.
Fresh.
No, that was good.
Okay. Oh, jeez.
Number 2 is the excellent Fuji XS10.
I loved using that camera.
Yeah, you had a blast using it.
It was a good camera.
It really does feel like they put most of what makes the X-T4 great in a much less expensive package. It's super light, but the grip felt great. It just feels like a premium product, but they're trying to throw it in that kind of mid-range entry-level class.
I had fun with it.
It's so good. It does a good job.
It was good.
I know you had fun. No, I could see you were having fun.
And the coveted number 1 position, best camera of 2020.
Best camera of the year, of this godforsaken year.
Because it's nothing to do with video, but photography only. Yes, we're going to give it to the Canon EOS R5.
As the best photography camera.
Yes, I mean, it is fantastic. It handles well, the interface is great, the image quality is stunningly beautiful, and the autofocus has come such a long way. I think everybody who plays with an R5 really enjoys this photographic experience. And the overheating issue doesn't really affect photography too much.
Okay, so those are our best cameras, but which ones did you have the most fun with that didn't
work? Yeah, we've got some honorable mentions this year. I mean, really, I would say, first off, the Leica Q2 Mono. Always
is the most fun you've had with a camera, I think,
when
we were filming.
Yeah, so much fun, right? Like, it was a really nice experience. And on that same regard,
it made you feel fancy.
As much as I hate 35mm lenses, the Fuji X100V.
Yeah.
The first X100 I actually enjoyed using. I normally don't like them at all, but it was a really nice experience. I mean, I love the weather sealing aspect that they've added.
I shot the entire episode on an X100V, a little street camera. It's so good at everything.
Right? Yeah. And you know what? I'm also going to give a mention to the Olympus EM1 Mark III. I think they've done
Because you were in Costa Rica.
No. That was great, though. But no, it's because they've really done a great job of adding computational aspects of photography to a system camera, and I think that's a great move, and nobody else seems to really have jumped on that. It's fast focusing, it's comfortable to use, and handled well. I was actually really blown away by the experience using that camera. And Costa Rica's f***ing great. This YouTuber used to be a professional singer, and they majored in it in college.
Dichi?
So,
did she respond to
us? She did not respond to us.
Okay, let's do that again.
Sorry. No. Yes, sir. They will like and comment on all of their friends' photos, along with expressing what a great photographer they are.
Oh, that's Sally Watson.
It is Sally Watson.
Nailed the gender.
I'm happy to drink that drink.
So big ups to your wife for the don't say name all in caps. Yeah, like, we're going to f*** that
she
up.
She knows you so well.
This is so well written. I'm in no state to read this. Here we go.
I'm going to Sherlock Holmes this.
This YouTuber once emptied a remote bar in rural Japan of squid fishermen with the opening words of Dean Martin's "Everybody Loves Somebody" on a karaoke machine. Driven by pride and embarrassment, the song was completed as a serenade to a lonely bartender now bereft of customers.
World traveler. Gordon. World traveler. Gordon.
It is Gordon.
No! Thank you, Gordon, you Japanese karaoke singing machine. Oh. I thought it was going to be something about coffee, obviously.
That was the second one.
All right, it's time to do best trends and worst trend of 2020. We're not gonna make it a big downer, but I mean, I think we're past
that. Succinctly.
Yes, succinctly. Okay, I'll try. So best trends, honestly, I think it's the year of the telephoto. We've seen so many awesome telephotos. I mean, you've got mentions like the Olympus 100 to 400, the Tamron 70 to 180 we talked about.
You're leading with the Olympus.
Ah, shut up. The Nikkor 70 to 200.
Yes.
Yes, but also like the Canon 70 to 200.
Panasonic 70 to 200. Yeah. The new Canon like 600, 800, F11.
Yes,
like, all that kind of, it feels like because they wanted to make small stuff when mirrorless first came out, they ignored telephotos. And now they're finally fleshing all those out. And we're seeing, I wasn't expecting to see a difference with mirrorless telephotos, but they're so good.
That sounds logical and reasonable, but the real answer is they staged COVID coming out with these telephoto lenses to keep us socially distanced. Yes.
I'm not endorsing this perspective. So, I mean, worst trend of the year, this is an easy one.
Yes, COVID.
But like photographically.
Inequality between incomes throughout the entire world.
Also something that's distressing.
Polarization of politics.
The worst trend in the photo video landscape, I think, is definitely overheating. It used to be really simple.
Global warming. Yes, I agree with you.
If Sony brought out like a crop sensor camera, you would test it for overheating and that was your overheating job for the rest of the year. But as all these companies are getting more and more ambitious, we're starting to see more and more cameras where overheating can become a real concern. I mean, the Canon is the obvious example of that.
Right. Ignore all the other stuff that I said. The true answer is, you know, your video shuts off a little bit earlier than you wanted it to because of overheating.
But then you're just sitting shooting with Levi, just sitting in the car under air conditioning, holding an R6, hoping that one day I'd be able to do
it. You are absolutely right. I 100% agree.
Maybe I lack perspective.
Yeah.
As the more coherent of the two of us at this point in the evening, I want to really quickly remind you, I'm doing great. Our success is rated by the number of subscribers that
That's
we can
true.
Grow. So, you know, we don't make you sit through mid-roll ads or pre-roll ads or end ads. I don't even know what those are called. So if you want to show your appreciation for that, now would be a really great time
and now
to
we're
subscribe
gonna do
on the thing.
A live rendition of The Love Shack by the B-52s.
No, we can't
the
afford that.
The Love Shack is a very... This is a great fact. Okay. This YouTuber's parents are immigrants, which I love, from Jamaica, being the son of an immigrant myself, and they are the first generation of their family born in the States.
I don't know who's left.
While Jordan...
Dan Watson.
Oh, you son of a...
Really?
You son of a...
Yes! It's a good fact.
I've decided I don't like B-52s anymore.
This YouTuber has no sense of smell. None. But don't worry, they can still taste.
Oh, I feel like we were sitting at a dinner table and this person said this. Gary, everyday dad.
No.
Oh!
That's okay. That's one shot. That's one shot. You can handle that. You're doing great. You're doing really well. They've been on several talk shows, including Good Morning America, after being dubbed the sexiest geek alive.
I'm going to go with Silver Fox, Tony Northrup. Oh,
that's right. Yeah. Well done.
Oh, really? He was on national news?
Yeah, it was a big deal.
Being quoted as the sexiest.
As a child, I was like, one day I could be as sexy as Tony Northrup.
Levi, you got to zoom in on the salt and pepper hair. That's bullshit. I win. Tony, you sexy beast. Oh.
Woo. Yeah, I don't.
This is worked
like
out.
It going in my mouth anymore.
I mean, I don't know. I've seen Tony Forbes' college picture, or Ted Forbes.
Holy
I've seen Ted Forbes' college picture. Yes.
Worst lens is really a tough category this year because there wasn't a lot of There were few bad lenses this year, and you know, I have to admit, I was kind of underwhelmed by the Tamron 24 and 20 millimeter lenses. It's a focal length I love. They were small and light.
How
but I wasn't
dare
crazy about...
you, sir? 24 and 20 mil is not 35 mil. The Tamron 35 millimeter, excellent lens optically if you care about that, is still a 35 mil. And the Sigma DGDN, this fire is so hot, is also a 35 millimeter. That's bad, bad news. Terrible lenses, garbage. You know, like zooms, 24 to 70, they should skip 35, just like hotels skip the 13th floor, Jordan. It's
34 to 36.
It's a travesty, and one day my people will be heard. In all seriousness, folks, the worst lens of 2020, we're actually going to give to the Fujifilm 50mm 1.0. The fact is, appealing to the crowd that wants the widest and the brightest and the biggest aperture, unfortunately, usually means major, major optical compromises, and the 50mm 1.0 Fujifilm was no exception. It was soft. Okay, so we're down to the final two, and obviously, we're not going to be able to play the game in the normal way because we know who's who, right? We've got it on our heads here. So this is what we're going to do. We're down to the last two. The guys operating the camera are going to say the last answer, the obscure answer.
The obscure
fact. Choice. We won't know whose it is. Okay? If you think you know, you take your shot, you down the shot, and you put the shot on the table. That's basically your buzzer. You then get to answer. If you get it right, the other person then has to take all three remaining shots.
Amazing.
If you get it wrong, obviously you have to take all three shots.
Well, then we'd move on to the next question.
No. You're gonna drink all three shots, Jordan.
This YouTuber won their junior high school prom's karaoke contest with Secret Agent Man.
Yes, it was Ted Forbes. Because Secret Agent Man is way too old for Gary, everyday dad.
Incorrect.
Oh, what? What?
Drink those.
Okay, first off, Gary, Secret Agent Man, and you won? I don't buy it. Lie. Fake news.
I used to play in my dad's band, and we played that song, Gary.
All right. Well, clearly, I concede defeat to you, Jordan.
You know we're not done yet.
No, it doesn't matter. The drinking game we are. This year, you have won fair and square. I commend
2 years in
you.
A row.
Let's do worst camera of the year.
I love it. Worst camera of the year, again, is a tough one because cameras have generally been pretty good this year, but there are some that are just like really disappointing upgrades. Like, I mean, the M50 Mark II from Canon was just a few like software updates on a camera that could really use some serious updates.
Yes!
It still has a bad 4K crop. It doesn't have the awesome like dual pixel AF2 system Canon's using in their latest cameras. It could be better. Something like the EM10 Mark IV is just not a pretty underwhelming
update.
But
the M5 Mark II is a gem. It's a gem.
The M5 Mark II?
That was like a long time ago. I'm up. It's the M6. Dude.
So the no. I think we should keep that in. So what's the worst camera of the year, Chris?
It's going to go to the Panasonic G100 because Jordan and I, and you'll know this, you'll attest to this, we have been asking for good vlogging cameras.
For 5 years.
5 years when it would have been relevant, right? Yeah. Now, Sony did come out with their camera, the ZV-1, and they did a great job of actually incorporating some features that would be useful to YouTubers and product photographers. I don't know if they're doing it. I'm not sure if influencers are using it. You let us know. But the G100, it misses the mark. The cool audio wasn't that cool.
They said it was built for vlogging, doesn't have an image stabilizer in the body, which Panasonic's famous for, doesn't have phase detect autofocus, so it still wobbles.
Yeah, honestly.
From shot to shot, has a heavy crop when you're shooting 4K.
I think a DJI Pocket 2 Osmo would be a way better choice now. The audio actually worked on that in that sort of all-around spatial sense better. And, you know, the gimbal's fantastic, and honestly,
it's less money and it's way bittier.
All right, that brings 2020 to an ignominious end. Well done. You beat me.
I did, again. 2 years in a row.
You should go back to physical games where I can destroy you.
I don't think beer pong is really a physical game.
It was so close. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed that. And honestly, like, first off, thanks so much to all the other YouTuber friends who helped us with this project. I mean, I learned a lot about them that I didn't know.
I feel like I'm closer with all of them.
Next time I see Chelsea, I'm going to ask her for a piano recital, like, done. So anyways,
if you missed some of those facts, we will be posting them on DPReview.com. If you go to the article attached to this video, you can read all the facts about all the YouTubers, because we did
actually
glaze through some of them. So
thank you so much to Levi and Behrad for helping us operate cameras.
Yes.
We kept all nice distances. We wore masks, but everybody had tea and coffee and beer, and they're all happy. Pizza. It was a great night. And you know what? Thank you so much for joining us here and subscribing. We've had big subscriber bumps. We really appreciate that for 2020. Tell 2020 to go f*** itself and hit that subscribe button right now on our channel. We'd really appreciate that. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. And
I couldn't have said it better, frankly. So thank you, everybody. We will see you all again in hopefully a much better... You know what? No, we still have videos coming out in 2020. We'll see you guys next week.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. That's not the... Okay, good night.